Today we have a video for you of a system we owned for more than 2 years, but recently we finally got it back working. It's an XCD Sorcerer, or in our case, the CompuData Sorcerer 2. The story of the Sorcerer is very interesting one, and it starts in 1978 when the founder of the Byte Shop, Paul Terrell, convinced the founders of XCD to create a truly simple computer with a reasonable performance. The Byte Shop is known for it being one of the first personal computer retailers and one of the first retailers to sell the Apple I computer. XCD, on the other hand, was selling coin-operated video game devices. Getting into creating a home computer was completely new for them. The machine is powered by a Zilog Z80 running at 2.1 MHz and has 4 to 48 kilobytes of memory. This all came in one case with a keyboard. Expansions could be done using the external S100 expansion unit or using packs. Here's an example of a pack. Packs were ROM-based in the housing of an 8-track tape, since they could get those cheap. Our pack has a version of BASIC in it, which was frequently used for the Dutch broadcast company Teliac, who chose this machine over the Belgium Die for the microcomputer course. 1 year later, the English BBC followed with the BBC Micro. Sales of the XCD were strong in Europe, especially in 1979 when the Teliac course started and the company CompuData imported these machines by thousands. CompuData even licensed the design so these machines could be produced locally. Therefore, this machine shows CompuData instead of XCD. In 1983, the CompuData Sorcerer was replaced by the Tulip System 1. With that, the CompuData name was changed into Tulip Computers. The other operating system was CPM by Digital Research. In order to boot this, we have to tell the computer that we need to read the disk. The command go bc00 makes the Sorcerer boot from the first drive. Now let's start a game to show the graphic capabilities of this machine. It's on the second drive, B, and after a listing we find pacman.com, so let's start that one. Here you have pacman.com, which is called Chomp, probably copyright or something. All graphics you see are coded into the character ROM. There's no direct drawing of pixels, only the characters provided by the ROM. Let's adjust the camera a bit. I guess you get the idea now. Let's try another game. The second game we're going to show is called Kilopede, so it must be at least 1000 times better than Millipede, right? Well, not really. See for yourself. For some reason, it was never a big hit in the US. Perhaps because of the Atari 800 and 400 and the Commodore PETs around the same time. However, it made a big impact in the Netherlands from the XCD Sorcerer. Tulip Computer became the fourth largest computer manufacturer in Europe and even ended up with the brand name Commodore. It's funny to see how brands are connected in some way or another. Even when shooting this video, I found out that the person who decided to buy 500 Apple I's is responsible for this magical computer. And for its time, it was a great machine. The only one capable of showing 64 characters on one line. And who doesn't like a game of chess? Again, only graphics coming from the character ROM here. Pretty amazing to see what they accomplished. I'm really happy that after 2 years we managed to get everything working, including the very rare S100 expansion unit and a Micropolis drive unit with the hard sector discs. When I was younger, I briefly had a Sorcerer, but I ended up giving it away. Therefore, I'm glad we're now able to have it fully up and running and set up hands-on in the Home Computer Museum. Thank you for watching, stay safe everyone, and if you like this video, please let us know in the comments and give us a thumbs up. We also have a Patreon link where you can support the museum and show us you like these videos too. Patreons get early access to videos and some inside information how we run the museum and upcoming projects. Link to the Patreon page and our social media channels are below. See you next time!